So the finale begins. Arc 2, Part 1 of the finale is here. We have the debut of Final Fantasy XV's Ardyn, as well as finally a reworked character in the form of Maria. Now, I do apologize for this video being a little late. Things have been a little crazy. I'm not going to go into too much detail, but things have been going a little crazy for work, and I just had to get a bunch of things situated and whatnot. So this video is going to be a little bit brief. We're just going to briefly cover the characters and talk about them. And just kind of go over, you know, their use just in a very brief format. So, let's hop in. Big shout out, as always, to the Tom Ray Drew for the lovely infographics that will be displayed in this video. Lovely group of people. If you're not following them on any of the social media platforms such as their Facebook and or Reddit, or giving their website a check, so make sure you go do so. And make sure you go give tons of love to Rem from the City of DB for the great database website that he provides with all the information that you could ever possibly need for the City of Final Fantasy Opera. Now, let's go ahead and start off with Maria. So, her rework pretty much just makes it so she now has battery on everything that she does, even her second skill that does still provide healing. Her EX now executes twice, and the debuff that gets inflicted, which is that trap-type debuff, doesn't break, but it will buff. It will give all allies brave based off of damage dealt. So, overall, the entirety of her kit, besides just the EX damage itself, gives battery. She has great support mechanics in the forms of healing and battery. Her auras and stuff for the party could be a little bit better. She has a physical attack up by 35%, attack up by 30%, and then the rest is just kind of mediocre. So if they aren't physical attackers, they're not really going to get the best out of Maria. So I wouldn't really slap her onto the team as like the primary support, just as a character who can be put on the team to do good range damage, as well as provide the party with some really great brave battery and some pretty solid healing. She covers a good amount of options and still provides a good enough amount of damage to really fulfill the role that she's meant to. Just know that you're not putting her on the team as a specific aura kind of character, just more for the battery and everything. That's where she lies. That's where her strength lies. So just keep that in mind, and Maria will do really well. She's actually very phenomenal. Now, Mr. Ardyn himself. So Ardyn is basically what Noctis is. But just does it a little bit more consistent. So Ardyn has a stackable frame buff. He gets a few stacks at the beginning of the quest. When he's over 3 or more stacks, he will always go up with a follow-up attack, which is a 3-hit single-target HP attack. After every single skill that he uses, he will follow up with this, which is actually pretty cool. He has some great AoE damage. His LD gives him a new frame buff called Overkill, which drops his HP to 0 and allows him to not die. He will actually not die while this frame buff is active. So as long as you keep it up and keep it managed, he will not die. When the buff resets, his HP will go back to 1. But in the meantime, you can be as aggressive as you possibly can, especially if you pair him alongside of a tank, someone like Bosch. If you pair him alongside one of those characters, you can be as aggressive as you possibly can with Ardyn with little to no drawbacks. His burst is a 15-hit HP attack, and the burst effect is pretty neat. It increases party's match brave, increases overall effects of everything that he does every time he breaks the target up to 2 times. It's good, and of course it's a burst and everything, but if it comes to the burst being important for Ardyn's kit, it's nothing on the scale of like what Noctis's is. Noctis's burst is just right now on a whole nother level, and it's kind of hard to compete with it. So, as important for his kid, not really, to be honest. You can fully realize Ardyn's potential even without the burst. As long as you get that LD, his kit will be fine. But a burst is a burst. If you're aiming to go for it, if you want to get it, by all means, go ahead. But just know that it's not something you necessarily need to dig for in order to realize Ardyn to his maximum capabilities. The burst effect sounds nice on paper, but it's not something that you're going to miss, and it's not something that you're going to cry that you're not going to have. You know what I mean? So overall, he's a phenomenal, phenomenal DPS unit. But just keep that in mind, that's all he's on the team to do. He's on the team to do damage. So make sure you're bringing alongside other characters to beef him up as best as you possibly can. And there we go, guys. That'll pretty much wrap it up for this one. We'll go back to the usual video format where I'm actually, talking a little bit more about the characters. Just time's been on a little crunch. So I apologize for this video being late. And hopefully we'll get back on track relatively soon. Thank you guys so much for watching. I'll see you next time.